This is unbelievable.
Holy. Unbelievable.
Holy shit!
Are you fucking serious?
Holy shit. Fuck,
it's massive.
It's my last day of the holiday break, and it's my first day game fishing for the season. And for a crew, I've got Biggs, my son Shaw, and cameraman Dan. Dan's on the rod because he's the only one on board that hasn't caught a swordfish before. So that means we're going to have to take over the cameras to record the action for you.
Got the shot, cameraman Shaw.
So here's what happens when you get up at 4:30 in the morning to go fishing and get dressed in the dark. You put your shirt on, inside out and the wrong way around.
That's the way, bro.
It's got your name in it, so you don't lose it. Good boy.
Here it comes. Oh, here's our top shot. Roll your shit, boys.
Come on, Dan, pull it in.
You're my boys.
Cutters just in case.
That there, right, okay. Yeah. I've got one on my belt, but never take one out of my belt.
Yeah.
Okay, it's sitting right there.
Far. I'm not even on the rod, my legs are shaking.
It ain't far, y'all.
This is rolling, we're all rolling. Get me that leader, just idle reverse, please.
There's your swordfish, I can see him. Oh, it's not a bad one, boy. Not a bad one.
Okay, your fish is caught. Okay, that was easy. Oh shit, it's not a little one. Get ready, I'm gonna probably have to dump this. Holy, it's a big one. Holy cow, are you just neutral to stay neutral? Holy shit, this thing's gonna go bad shit. Reverse right hand down. Yeah. Get ready, I'm gonna have to let go, Dan. This thing is lit up. It's a big one, boy. Okay, neutral. Here he comes, he's gonna break the surface right here, Shaw. This fish is gonna pop up right here, Shaw. It's a big one, mate. Oh. Look, there it is, boy. Okay, look, it's a big one.
It's a
massive one, bro. Let him go.
Holy.
That's a big one, boy.
That's
a big one, eh? Look at my hand, it's giving the crush. We've caught the fish because we've had it on the leader, but it could be hours till we see it again. Many hours for Dan.
Looking forward to it.
Did you hear that? Looking forward to it. Oh, I love that shit. It's charging back up at us. We might get some anger next time it turns up on the boat. If that load comes back on, we'll let you have a drink.
It's early on, but we've got to keep Dan hydrated because the adrenaline's soon going to wear off. And this fish is big. And swordfish have got incredible power and endurance. And I've seen these big ones destroy anglers. And this fish is just warming up.
Ain't nothing yet, mate. Hasn't even started doing shit.
Woo! Yep, that little giggle there. That's because I know what Dan is in for.
A fresh looking Dan. Before. Reverse up the line, just back up. Yeah. Give it a little bit, Biggs.
Yeah, keep coming around, right hand down, right hand down, right hand down.
The fish is up on the surface now and it's charging away from us. So we're chasing it, for one, to take the load off the line and to help Dan. But if this thing pops up, we want to be right there so we can get a close look at it.
You everything tight, Dan?
Yeah.
The fish is swimming fast, eh? It's gonna, that way, Bix, hard, Bix. Slow down. There's the fish. There's the light. That way, Bix, reverse that way.
Rolling all this shit. Okay, go neutral.
Okay, go forward, excuse. Go forward so I can grab that leader, eh? Forward, right hand down. It's a big one, boys. Forward, right hand down. Yeah, that's it.
Biggie, it's the swordfish version of you, Biggs.
Yeah, this is a big boy, right?
That's what I said, Jess. It could be even bigger than we think. Okay, you straighten up a little bit, Biggs, yeah. We got this fish working now, eh? Look, he's always coming back up. He's coming back up. Come around, keep coming around. Yep, chase him down. He's gonna break. Come on, break. Come on, look, he must be right up on top. It's changing direction, this fish. Might have to lean out here, Dan. Yep, good work. Okay, slow down now. Button off. That was good. Good work. That's what we need to be able to do.
This is gonna be a long one, no matter what we do. And of course, there's 100 ways we can lose the fish at any stage. So we need to be careful, maneuver the boat right, fight this fish carefully, but we can't afford to be too conservative. We've got to go hard as well. Otherwise, we'll never get it in. While we're out here fighting this fish, we're able to give live updates to our followers on Facebook. We've got this PowerTech Selfie aerial installed, so we've got full coverage way out here. So if you don't already follow us, look up the ITM Fishing Show and Ultimate Fishing, follow both, and with our new coverage and streaming ability, you'll be able to see more of this stuff as it happens.
So we're about 2.5 hours in now, and not a whole lot's changed.
This fish has been going between 20 and 40 meters down from us, and it's just trucking due north, swimming out to sea. And we can just make it out when it's 20 meters down on the GoPro, but it's showing no sign of fatigue. It's basically doing what it wants. We're not holding it up at this depth. This is the depth that it's chosen, and we're pretty much just following it. Basically, we've not made a dent in this fish yet. But hey, at least Dan's spirits are high. Yeah, there's that giggle again. And that's because I know that this is just the beginning.
Oh yeah, that is hissing, that's good. See, we're getting him to work, we've just got to stop him getting into those, letting him get into those rhythms he's been getting into. And that's after 5 hours.
How's he going, Big? Tell us from a man who's caught one before.
5 hours now?
He's going alright, eh?
He's a bit quiet.
I know all the phases of swordfish emotion.
That's it.
You don't even know what phase you're in because you don't know what you don't know.
Just sitting there whining.
Yeah.
We know this is a big one, but we've not had a clear enough look to know exactly how big it is. Even so, we've not got the gaffs out. Dan said he wants to tag it even though it's his first, and well, that's fine by me.
What, 6 hours must be, eh?
6 hours, yeah.
Yeah.
6:10.
Whee! Could be in for a long one.
Seven and a half hours, and that line is pissing off the reel.
She's still pulling.
Oh! Oh, you've inflated your life jacket!
Safety first, eh? First time I've ever seen one deploy a life jacket in their sleep.
This Telica 50 is spooled up with 700 metres of 100 pound Power Pro with 70 metres of 130 pound mono top shot. And Dan's fishing a sunset drag of 20 kilos plus clamping on the spool. We've got the big strong rope and we're putting some heat on.
Woohoo!
Yeah. Oh. Wind sea's getting up a bit.
Now we're fishing.
Getting a little bit rougher. Forecast 20 knots of wind has kicked in. Got a bit of a sea building. And we're in reverse. We're backing into the sea. This boat is incredible. We're going backwards into this and look at this, we're dry. Backing up into the sea. Now get the fish down so we can use that bit of footage. We've stayed a carpet plug. I'll break its spirit soon. Oh, there, it'll break yours.
Yeah, perfect.
Oh! Back to the bray. Bye bye, mono.
God.
Bye bye. Look at that, purring away. Look at us humming. Goodbye line.
She's still going.
Getting ready for an all-nighter. Far North Radio from Godamon.
Godamon, Far North, good evening, go ahead, over.
Hey Annette, Happy New Year. Just a quick TR from us. We're four persons on board this evening. We're currently sort of due north of the Ninepin Trench. We're fighting a fish. Been going for 10 hours and the end's not in sight. So just letting you know that we might be out here this evening. Over.
You've been on a fish for 10 hours, did you say? Wow, how's your angler coping? Over.
Remarkably well, all things considered. So. Yeah, we'll stick with it, but yeah, we're currently at 34-44-174-20. Thanks, Annette. Got them on clear. Standing by.
Thank you very much. That'll pay out.
Getting your sunblock ready for the morning.
I might be having a laugh, but I'm getting anxious about catching this fish. I want it caught, because I don't want it to be a story about the giant one that got away. So all we can do is stay vigilant, stay tight, don't make mistakes. And it feels right now like we may never get it, but the sea's calmed down now, and so long as we can stay connected and just stay in the fight. We hook this thing in the morning and you literally just don't envisage fighting into the night, and mentally that's what's tough. Never mind how physically exhausting this is for Dan. The adrenaline's all gone from him now and his muscles are burning. So now it's just grit that keeps you going, and that single-minded desire to get a close look at this monster. It's that literal being in a fight with a giant that gives you strength and pushes you to places, and you can do things you otherwise could not do. The fish is close, but it's still got loads in it. And Dan, well, not so much. You can literally see the pain now. Dan is real close to beating this thing, but I mean, he can't last much longer.
There it is, okay. Just there it is. Just neutral for a second, please, Biggs. I just want to see what this fish is going to do. Oh, he's real close there, Dan. Mate, how tough are these things that just will not give up? Good shit. There you go. There you go. Woo, you're leaking a bit, bae. Give it a little bit, please, Biggs. Just a little bit, please. It's a big fish, mate.
I've got the leader again, 12 hours after I last had it in hand. And this time, we can say, yep, Dan, you've caught it. But the fish isn't ready to give up, and we still haven't had a good look at it.
Left hand down, look at the side. Oh, neutral, shit. Neutral, neutral.
We've just had our first good view of this fish, and now I've got to try and hold on to this thing.
Give it some.
Oh, sorry, Dan. Right hand hard down. I couldn't hold it, mate. So how about you just wind him back up for me, eh?
Ah, shit. Double knot right here, Dan. So close, mate. Rod here. Yeah, that's it, Dan.
It's so close. It's
bit,
right there. We can see it. But
perfect.
It's still full of power. And Dan is now completely gassed. We've got within inches of that leader several times, but there's a point where no amount of grit will get you there. If I thought this fish was done, I'd keep pushing Dan to keep going. But the best thing to do is get the big man in and somehow try and finish this fish.
This is incredible. Listen, this fish is still going hard. We've been able to see it for about the last 3 hours. Biggs is on the rod now. Dan's just done an honest 14-hour stint. And it's what, about 1 a.m. 1 a.m. And this fish is still going hard. Unbelievable. How this fish
has picked up his second stamina
after I haven't had a mad more, mate. I haven't had enough sleep. 10, that's 12, 15 hours. After 15 hours, this fish is going, and now it's honing out the big man. This is, I don't know, you tell him, B.
Damn, mate, what did you do to the
fish? What have you done? What,
nothing, mate.
Someone tell me what's happening here.
Someone tell me what's happening.
What's the time, Dan? 15 hours?
No, longer than that, bro.
16, 17?
Yeah, 20 to 2 now.
Almost got the chase and then we got peeled.
Oh, shit. This is 16 hours. This is 16 hours and look at this. Explain it to me, Biggs. What's happening?
I don't know. I feel like Dan did. Very confused.
Helpless.
Helpless, yeah.
And here was me going,
before you got onto the line.
Hey. I'm getting worried because I might hit, at this rate, I might have to end up on the rods.
Yeah. Just to wake up short.
Yeah.
Holy. The longest sword fight I've been involved in was 16 hours and 40 minutes. And that was when I was working on the prime time. And that swordfish got sharked. And we got an even bigger one from my little boat a few years back. That was 11 hours, and that one got sharked too. So as this fight goes on, I'm starting to worry about a shark. I think the bigger risk is that fatigue and lack of sleep could cause us now to make a mistake. And after all we've been through, it would be devastating not to finish this off now.
Here it is.
Right hand down.
Yep.
I'm just clipping myself onto the boat here. And that's because I'm just going to wrap up and try and hold on to this thing. And I don't want to get dragged over, particularly in the dark.
Forward.
Grab the tackle, Sean. Poke it in that fish.
Poke the fish.
Poke now.
Got it.
Yes!
Yes.
Yeah. Fucking hell!
Holy
fucking
serious!
Holy shit!
You're wrapped on the rod tip. You're wrapped on the tip. Okay. Holy fuck! Holy fuck!
How big is that fish?
400 people. We got that! What? We got that! That's like a worldie, bro. Look at the tail. Look at the tail.
Holy shit.
Just roll every camera that we have.
Sure, can you get the whole camera
going? Let him go, get ready.
Holy shit, that's fucking...
We got a tag in him!
Yeah. Sure woke up to put the tag in him.
I'm like, oh, don't
where?
Sure.
I'm like, poke him!
So the fish has been tagged, but we still need to finish this properly by getting it away in good condition.
Approaching 17 hours. Now he's doing that to us.
That's a nice shadow this drop.
Look at that go! Now you look, 17 hours, that beast of a fish is still fighting like that, and that is because we've got a circle hook. Now circle hook, incredibly strong, but it means that you get the absolute best out of the fight of a fish. Some people come out here with J hooks, hook magnificent fish like this, wind them in 20 minutes or an hour, because I've choked them, and they say they've caught a big swordfish. They ain't caught a swordfish. This is catching a swordfish. Oh.
I really don't know how big this thing is. I've caught over 100 of these. The biggest 326 kilo, and this is a lot bigger than that. But because all swords are different shapes, it's hard to say with swordfish. Just how big this one is, I don't know, but it doesn't matter. What matters is we've got it. And it is one fish I will not forget. And I'm sure these guys won't forget it either. Dan was a machine, so was Biggs. And it was great for sure to be out here and be part of it too.
Oh, Dad.
Okay.
Here it goes. There it goes. It's right. It's swimming away. Beauty too.
It's swimming away, beauty.
Yeah, Dad.
I hope you guys out there have enjoyed coming on this adventure with us. It was pretty raw and unplanned, but I guess that's what makes it an adventure. And of course, we've got loads more of this on ultimatefishing.tv, including all of the how-to videos on the rigs we use for swordfish or anything that we catch. So you guys can check all of that out and get amongst one of the last true adventures left on Earth that any person can just get out here and do. And that is going out and catching an incredible fish. So you'll get all of the action and all the how-to videos for free on ultimatefishing.tv. Even better and easier, just download our free app. And finally, I've got to give some genuine credit to this gear. The Shimano Talica 50, what it's been through is incredible. And of course the boat, Stabycraft, so safe and sound. I love this boat. And this E-Tech has run non-stop for 26 hours on this trip without missing a beat. So there you go. Check out more of our stuff. Thanks for following our adventures. We'll see you on the next one.